protest and silent protest. Basic thing, what is the problem with politics? Only corruption. Everywhere there is corruption. Everybody is getting into some problem, or everybody is putting others into problem only because of their avarice. So that is corruption. Corruption, everybody says that getting money is corruption. Not only getting money is corruption. Corruption is defined in Shastras in a deeper sense. Corruption basically it is favoring a person by anything for reward snatching and risk avoidance. For getting a benefit, it may be a revenge, it may be a reward, it may be revenue. And also to avoid some risk. So risk avoidance, reward, revenue and revenge. The third thing, whenever you favor somebody, promote somebody on the feelings of any bondage between caste, religion or language, etc., that is also corruption. And reasonless prejudice for a capable, competent, deserving person, that is also corruption. Unlawful obedience for your superior officers, that is also corruption. If you want recognition and reputation in society, you do some unlawful encroachment, that is also corruption. So corruption is multifold. It is not only bribery, embracery or getting money. So corruption is multifold. These things can be very effectively done only when good people jump. That is why Plato told, these type of dirty politics, they are developed not by the careful nourishment of the dirty elements, but the negligence of the clean elements of the society. They are developing only by us, only by our negligence. The development for them is only just by the manner of our negligence and non-participation. We have to do, and we have to dismantle the four pillars of modern politics. What are the four pillars of modern politics? Bribery, murder, forgery and fraudulence. Without these four things, political game and gambling, they cannot be conducted. And certainly a dawn must come, and God must throw light upon divine persons, so that divine persons should rule. It may not be even theocracy. Persons who obey divine orders, persons who believe in divinity, persons who are practical benevolence of divine Shiva, persons who are worshippers of God, are divine divinity personified, irrespective of the status of being either a saint or a sage or even a scholarly person, or a benevolent dictator like Rama Parikshita used to say, they are benevolent dictators. Such a person either God, godly, God-made, God-sent person, they must come for rule. Then only we can create the benefits. Then finally coming to electoral reforms. Why we are calling electoral reforms? Because our country is ruled by democracy. So democracy has the electoral methodology, so we have to create electoral reforms. Nature and selectivity. Nature and selectivity. For example, if you keep a ruby and a worm, or a ruby and a dead rat before a crowd, which will it select? There is a dead rat and there is a diamond. Both start with D, let us keep. A crow is asked to select something which is very valuable. Which one is select? Only the dead rat or dead body. Because it cannot evaluate that ruby or diamond. Likewise, nativity, nature and selectivity. These things are interconnected. If you ask fools to form a group and select some person, then immediately they will select a high-end fool or a person who can fool them in turn. If rogues are elected, are given the opportunity to elect somebody, they will bring some high-end rogue. So this is the nature. For example, I want to say something. Just as there must be a rule or a regulation or a principle of eligibility for the person elected, so it is known as, in surgery, can you select a doctor by appearance or by your relation? We can select the people for each and everything, even to stitch your clothes, you search for a good tailor. For each and everything, you take good clothes, good food, you want everything good with good brand. Then in selection, why you are in negligence, why you are very much poor and underrated? You must select only good people. Can you select somebody, your neighbor as he is a close friend for 30 years, can you give the surgical weapon for operation without going to a capable doctor? So it is also a social surgery, national surgery, in which the unwanted elements are evil elements, are degradable elements of the society, they are totally put apart by excision, and the social structure and salubrity is maintained by a vigilant movement. So it is also a type of seriousness and sincerity, and it must not be just given for option or for some other useless things. So it must be properly selected, they must be taught how to select, or their selection right must be confiscated. So these two things are, the second thing cannot happen in the constitutional position of modern India. But still, if the selectivity. Either we have to teach them the democratic right and value. The second thing, at least if they are not properly behaving, their right must be totally confiscated. If that thing is not possible, do this. There are two commissions. We know only about the election commission. Second is the public commission. The commission of the public, the integral federal public and the decides. They decide a lot of things. The election commission can do a lot of things. I have already told about image building, suppression, a lot of other things are there. They can get into those areas. Like don't advertise much and don't bribe people. So conspicuously don't do that in our presence or as those things are coming to our notice. So without our notice or knowledge, anything may be practiced. So electoral reforms are very limited. It is disqualification of a party or a person for his malpractices or for prosecution and limitation of the norms for conducting elections in which a just way of the election rights of the people can be executed. Is the election commission doing anything for creating vigilance about the sense of electivity in the public? Is that included in the election commission's norms? It is not there. So that is why it is blind, it is unilateral, it is useless, it is fit for nothing itself. Why you are restricting those people? You restrict these people. There are only few hundreds. There are lakhs of crores of people, those who are going to determine. And who is there to control the person's vehemence or disordered projection? Or who is there to tune knowledge and awareness? And who is the person to relieve them from stupidity, swan stupidity, voluntary stupidity, committed idiocy? Who is there to retrieve all of these people? Only public commission, NGOs and good stalwarts from the society, they have to do these things. The society is totally disorganized and scattered by means of language favor, community or caste favor, religious favor, some craze, political leaders or senior actors, some craze. The fifth thing is benefit loyalty. He will give me some post, he will give me some benefit, some power share, some wealth share, something I have already told you. So this is communal favor. Second thing is religious favor. Third thing is removal favor. Fourth thing is craze. Fifth thing is benefit loyalty. So all these things have made the society to be scattered so that they need not be united again to have a vigilant look who is going to be elected and who is going to be controlled. So it is they are carefully maintaining the society in such a manner that they will not be integrated at any cost at any time again. So this is the society. So we have to create two things. One is for the budding youths and for the already blossomed youth generations who are having the voting rights, we have to teach them democratic awareness and democratic training. Second thing is very wonderful and even humorous. It is vote value. Each and everybody is casting a vote. Vote has a value. There must be created a vigilance about vote value. That is vote value vigilance program, triple V program, in which we have to say two things as per their own language. One is disproportionate benefit. Second is last burden. We have to say that MLA, he has given you 500 rupees or 1000 rupees, but the wealth that he has gained is 50 lakhs or 50 crores. Second thing is last burden. Whatever the black money that is circulated by these people in the society that will enable and empower them to purchase a lot of properties, and without proper supply, the demand will be more, the prices will shoot up. Then immediately there will be crisis, hike up in prices, it will create inflation in the society. So that last burden will be in the form of either taxation or interest rate being leveled high in banks, which will come only to the fate of the skull of the person, the subject. So the loss is burden on you, and you are getting only 500, he is getting 50 lakhs. Improportionate benefit and last burden, by which the persons must be tuned or tutored to ask for higher demands or greater demands. What is higher demand? Higher demand is, I am not ready to vote you for 500 rupees, give me 5 lakhs. So, 1000 people within a village, they must take a determination that unless you give 5 lakhs, we won't vote. We will select somebody else. That is higher demand. Greater demand is, you put road, bring electricity, do all these things. So, this must of vigilance and courage must be brought in the public. It is known as triple V, vote value vigilance. Then ending with India once more, India has given, lot of people they have given lot of things, inventions we have seen, lot of westerners. What is the use? The basic qualities for life, three things are given only from India. The knowledge of India, the experience of India, the estimation of India, the realization of the Indian sources. So the first thing is